So, welcome to the Mobility Dataspace Breakout Session. Hello, everyone. The session will be moderated by Wolfgang Inninger from Fra and me, Sebastian Preach. I think we wait a few seconds in order to wait for some new participants from who are currently maybe still in the farewell session, and we will start shortly. Okay, I do not see any further new parties. So Wolfgang, I would say let's start. Yeah, welcome again. So your host for today, this is me, Sebastian Preetsch from Fraunhofer IBI. I'm head of a research group for data systems and travel assistance, and I'm the coordinator of the Fraunhofer Mobility Dataspace Initiative, which is a verticalization of the IDS. And for the current ongoing activities regarding the German Datenraum Mobilität, data space mobility, I'm the technical solution architect. Wolfgang, maybe you can tell some words about you.
Hello, welcome everyone. I'm from the Fraunhofer IML. We are located in Prien at Lake Chiemsee in Bavaria. And we are working on traffic, mobility, and environment topics, coordinating also the Fraunhofer Transport Islands and the Fraunhofer Leitmark Mobilität, which I will explain later in my speech. And I'm also coordinator of the EIT Urban Mobility Think Tank data. So it's an EIT Urban Mobility community where Fraunhofer is active, and I have to coordinate some topics around mobility and data, and we will also explain later more there. Thank you.
Okay, and last but not least, we have a third technical co-host, which is Mr. Reinhardt from MMC Events. He will support the session on a technical level. If you encounter some technical problems, please use the chat functionality. Hopefully he will be able to solve problems that we encounter. You are all muted by default. If you have any questions, please post them in the chat. We have three very short presentations that we will give you today. And after each presentation, we try to tackle the questions that you have. And after this presentation slot, we will try to make an more open discussion. So let's start. In this session, we want to tackle how we apply the IDS principles in the mobility domain. We want to briefly show which are the problems that occur, where are the main fields that we need to tackle, and we show you the current state of play, which activities have started based on this Mobility Data Space initiative. So a short recap, which you might have seen earlier today. The IDS is a data space reference architecture for secure and sovereign data exchange, and it explicitly support domain specific data spaces. And this is more and more crucial when we go deeper into the specific domains. And Mobility Data Space is a domain specific initiative where we tackle domain specific problems in mobility, where we try to bring up new solutions for mobility providers in order to have a more flourishing data exchange and data utilization. So what's generally the scope of mobility? Maybe we approach this from the traveler's perspective. What a traveler expects is that he has access to European-wide multimodal travel information service that are well integrated, and that the traveler is able to access cross-sectoral information, booking, navigation services, and payment. So that's the expectation, but we are very far from that at the moment. Another perspective is the mobility service provider. This is either the one that conducts a specific transport service, or it's a mediator that provides or operates a platform or a smartphone app who integrates mobility offers in one single access point. Also from this perspective, it is crucial to have access to all operators, to all offers, make them combinable, make them comparable. So for mobility data space, this means we need to make local and regional data visible and accessible on a national and European level. So what you encounter is oftentimes that mobility is a local service from your local city, for example, but it's not possible to access these information, to access these services from a national point of view. So it's very difficult to dive deep into the local mobility operator. What we also see is that we have in the mobility domain different sectors. You have railways, you have aviation, you have private transport. These are very sectoral or divided domains, and it's very hard to bring them together because interoperability between systems and data is often not there. And a new and very challenging task is how can we bring new data into this ecosystem? How can we make personal or sensitive mobility data more utilizable, for example, for these operators, in order to bring new on-demand services to the customer, new tailored demand services, in order to meet very specific individual needs. So let me give you a short recap on the IDS technical architecture. So what IDS is all about is bringing data provider and data consumer together and provide trust between them. So I'm not going to deep into the principles, but IDS provides trust and secure data utilization, and therefore we have a very interesting means exploiting and utilizing new and sensitive mobility data. When you bring two stakeholders together, you basically have a first data space connecting them via the IDS connector constitutes the data space. The interesting part is now this is a decentral architecture, decentral system. Now we can bring in more and more additional peers to that network, and we can this ecosystem by, let's say, 500 new participants that offer and exchange data. So what we need in such a decentral large ecosystems are central services, which the IDS has conceptualized, which are a central data directory where you can provide and publish data offers where you can search for data that you need for your business processes. We have data app stores, which is not comparable with your data app store on your smartphone, but it's more imaginable like a source of data models, a source of AI software components that you can use inside of your connectors in order to work and utilize with the data. We need some special other services like an identity provider who provides certificates and authorization of participants, and we need a common understanding of the language and the data models that we are working on, and a vocabulary provider is providing specifically this information, and moreover connection points between different data models, data formats. Our goal is in the first run to identify data platforms in the mobility domain, because they have already a specific ecosystem around this platform. They have an operator which has a business model. Our goal is in the first place how we can connect data platforms with each other. How can we make data platforms more attractive to data providers in order to use these platforms, in order to trust these platform operators? And our most significant goal at the moment is how can we extend these data platforms with IDS concepts in order to widen and broaden these data ecosystems. Of course, when you look at one platform, there is one ecosystem, but the ultimate goal should be to also connect data platforms with each other to make data visible amongst platforms. And you can see this on different levels. We want to combine or connect the regional the data platforms which you have in cities, in municipalities, with the national level, let's say the national access points, like in Germany, the MDM, or even one step further, national access points and data platforms on a cross-border level between different EU member states, for example. So which are the current activities, or which is the state of play at the moment with mobility data space? So we started in 2017 with the first studies, which then have been extended by a larger research project funded by the Ministry of Transport in Germany, which has a large number of project partners, and we try to constitute a first ecosystem with data providers and users. We have supported the federal ministry further develop the functionalities of the current national access point for mobility data, which is the mobility data marketplace in Germany. There is now a large tender for a new development of this platform, comprising all the data space concepts that I have shown previously. And we expect this new data platform be in operation in 2022. A very interesting activity is the IDSA mobility community, which has been in operation for a few months now. T-Systems is in charge of the coordination there. There is Chris Langdon, the contact person, who unfortunately couldn't join us today. But I've seen Sven Löffler from T-Systems. If you are a member of the IDSA, are interested in working on mobility topics together with us, please contact Chris Langdon, Sven Löffler, or me, and we will bring the ideas together in the IDSA community. A further interesting activity also from T-Systems is intermodal journey use case within the Real Labor Hamburg, which is coordinated by the NPM, the National Platform of Mobility in Germany. Further, there's a huge activity going on right now in Germany, which is called Datenraum Mobilität or Data Space Mobility, which is driven by the German Chancellery and the Federal Ministry of Transport. And the vision is also to constitute a federal and cross-sectoral mobility data space. This is going far beyond what we are seeing in the MDM. The MDM here will be for its own or on its own be extended by IDS principles, but it is focused mainly on public sector mobility data. The Datenraum Mobilität will tackle a cross-sectoral approach and even bring in private data from automotive sectors here. Also here, we need those central IDS services like the broker identity provider, which I presented you earlier. There's a very keen time schedule for this initiative. We want to bring this Datenraum into operation next year, which will be on an interim operation provided by Fraunhofer. And then we seek for a dedicated operator which will run the system in the long term. A short glimpse on the European perspective. These activities that I showed you mainly tackle the German market, but there is a strategy from the European Commission from February this year, constituting that there should be a common European mobility data space connecting the sectors of the European member states. I think we have a very good position in order to play in specific part in this activity in the future. Please go check out our white paper on mobility data space. Our website is mobilitydata.space. This white paper shortly describes the action points and the architecture that we are using. And this white paper is available in German and English. Okay, so far from the current state of play and the technical view on the mobility data space. Thank you very much. And now is the time that you can raise some questions that I try to answer right now. And then we skip to Wolfgang. Okay, first question, are you working together with Gaia X Domain Mobility? We are working in this mobility community. We are in touch with DLR and Frank Köster. Currently the state of play is that we are still looking for use cases that will be integrated into projects that will be then run under the Gaia X umbrella. Okay, then the other question, is there an overlap of the Datenraum Mobilität? I hope that I answered this question with my slides, that there is this overlap, that the mobility data space will constitutes the technical architecture for Datenraum Mobilität, and second will provide the interim operation for the Datenraum Mobilität. And so yes, there's a huge overlap. Is there any documentation related to the sensitive data aspect? No, there is no documentation for that. This is the most specific point that we tackle actually in a research project right now. So IDS promises to make sensitive data exploitable, but in a secure way. So in a nutshell, that you can prohibit the exploitation of data in a way that you that the data owner didn't allow. And we are tackling this very question right now in a research project where we look on personalized data like motion data from private cars, from navigation systems, and motion data from mobile networks. And we are closely working together with GDPR experts and official departments in order to find a holistic way in order to make this data utilizable under the data space concept. Okay, and Sven also mentioned the mobility data space community from the IDSA. There is the link. If you are an IDSA member, that's the contact point where you can reach out to Sven or Chris. Okay, I see no further questions. Then, Wolfgang, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Sebastian. So to have a start and a little bit interaction, we prepared some questionnaires. And I'd like to ask you if you tell us about from which business you are from, so that we have an idea where you're from and what your interests in. So I start this questionnaire, and I hope this works well, and you can give us a feedback on this. Okay, it's working, and it seems that there are some software companies or experts in some consultancy and some research, some vehicle manufacturer, and not yet any mobility service provider or public or private transport provider. Okay, that's very interesting. One third is other business, so we wouldn't have fit perfect name of the businesses, but interesting, it's not changing anymore now. So I close this and show you the question and end it by now. Thank you very much. And in the next step, I will start my presentation. And hope you all can see this. Sebastian, would you give me a short feedback if everyone can see my slides?
Yes, it's visible.
Okay. So, thank you for your interest from my side as well. I just like to inform you in short about two activities we are actually involved in and which have relation to mobility data space, of course. So Fraunhofer is developing now new initiatives called Target Leading Market, and we are responsible at Fraunhofer EML for the mobility economy leading market. And there is an action about to define products and services which are coming from the Fraunhofer Transport Alliance and to develop systemic solutions for these leading markets. We are also responsible for industrial associations. And as you can see, it's not only mobility, it's also other leading markets which will be addressed within this project in the next years. So for the leading market, for all topics of mobility, we started in the beginning of the year, and we also had already within the network of Fraunhofer Transport Alliance some working groups dealing with the topic of automotive, commercial transport, rail, people mobility, and waterborne. And out of these working groups, we developed some, of course, goals and functions regarding here the market, the R&D, the development of integral mobility solutions, and also to have some innovation boost and to transfer knowledge by identifying market needs and setting trends within this market, of course. For some Fraunhofer institutes involved, you can see a short list here, and we are all over Germany active in these different topics. For leading market mobility, the speaker is Professor Dr. Uwe Clausen, which is also head of department within the Fraunhofer IML. And I'm responsible for representative topics and bringing the solutions from the working groups together. And in all working groups, we have the topic of digitalization, of course. So in the working group people mobility, for example, we are working on connected mobility topics, platforms, mobility as a service solutions, integrated or integration of mobility in urban spaces, intermodality, interoperability, and cooperation between transport modes. Also new and sharing mobility is a big topic. In the working group automotive, it's more technical driven, and in the commercial transport working group, it's more dealing, of course, with commercial transport topics. And in rail, it's also a little bit about automatization in rail transport, about maintenance, and about conducting and monitoring railroad infrastructure, for example. In waterborne, it's more about shipping solutions, autonomous shipping, inland navigation, and all these topics around the harbor. We identified that the big data or live data use, of course, is a big challenge, and that there are a lot of connections within all these working groups and market fields. And so we try to force the mobility data space as a good possibility to combine data from different markets, of course. So you can see it here a little bit in short, and we are dealing with cars and with trucks and with street and intermodal solutions about logistics, ships, harbors, infrastructure, and everything else. So we have common infrastructure, we have common physical and digital infrastructure, we have common mobility market. Of course, for people mobility and commercial transport, it's a little bit different market, but all together we have the possibility to use live and big data, and there are challenges about privacy and data sovereignty, of course, And with a combination and for processing of data, we can create additional value and additional services. So all this leads to new processes and new mobility services at the end, hopefully. Here, a short picture, which shows a little bit the idea of the mobility data space in a practical use, for example, within people mobility. And if you would imagine that we have would have developed this mobility data space and integrated a lot of player in this field, from commercial data provider or commercial mobility provider and data from public transport provider, additional free data and data from cities, regions, infrastructure data. This could be a good basis for international mobility as a service solution or a platform or a connection between mobility as a service solutions. So this is shown a little bit in this picture here. If you have different mobility as a service solutions in different cities, in different countries, it's also a challenge to bring at the end this data together. So for example, international business traveling man would be interested, of course, in using this functionalities also on international trips. So we hope mobility data space could help also in this challenge to get more international. And regarding getting more international, I'd like to show you in short the initiative EIT Urban Mobility, which is a KIC community about mobility in cities, of course. And you can find more information, of course, in this shown link, eiturbanmobility.eu. And here, just a short picture about some cities you see in the middle, which are already core partners in this EU EIT project. You see some logos from industry partners, which are already partners and knowledge institutes and universities. We started with this project in 2020, so it's still valid until 2027, and there are some funding possibilities within this network, but of course not all of the 400 million euro would be for innovation projects. I think something about the half of this would be available for innovation projects. Fraunhofer is here core tier one partner, and we are also forcing some activities within this EIT Urban Mobility regarding, of course, data and mobility. And we introduced a think tank about data and mobility last year, and this year, in beginning of March, we had in Eindhoven the second think tank. This was my last business trip before the COVID, by the way. And we discussed a lot of things there together with the cities, with the partners. And cities also identified that data is one of the six most important challenges within urban mobility. Yeah, targets, of course, is to identify and to discuss the more detailed data challenges and existing ideas or solutions and use cases, and to provide compatibility between existing tools, specific applications, or specific regions, cities, or countries. And one aim could be to have a Europe-wide competitiveness in order to standardize data exchange regarding mobility data. Yeah, most identified important topics and application areas here in a nutshell. is of course safety and data privacy, standardization, data ownership, business models is also very important for the cities, of course, and for the industry, the data value chain, and also education about using data, using free data or using commercial data, of course. Functional application areas are about traffic control related data, but also a main focus is on public transport related data, connecting mobility as a service solutions, infrastructural administrative city data, and also data regarding logistic aspects. And at this point, I like to show you another questionnaire asking you about your opinion about functional application areas. And I like to start the next question to you. So do you think what are the most important functional application area for you? So you can give us a feedback about this, and I will be very hard looking forward what we can expect here. So we have most of you thinking that traffic related data is very important. Next will be public transport related data and infrastructural data. These are the most important functional application areas at the moment. I wait another 10 seconds. And then I can show you. Yeah, I think you can see now what the questionnaire is about important functional application areas for you. Thank you very much for this feedback. And I go back to the presentation. Yeah, thank you very much. So this is, in a nutshell, something about Fraunhofer Transport Alliance, Fraunhofer leading market mobility and digitalization tasks we are dealing with there, and also about EIT Urban Mobility and the think tank about data here. Thank you very much. From this point, if you have any more questions, I try to answer now. Sebastian, you can help me if you like.
Yes, of course. So I don't see any further questions right now. So there was a question regarding the presentation material. I think there will be public versions available afterwards. I think the organization or the coordinator of this event will be providing these materials afterwards. Okay, but do you have specific questions for Wolfgang and the involvement in this community? So the communities that we are tackling at the moment, like Datenraum Mobilität, EIT Urban Mobility, and also our Leitmarkt activities, are open to further stakeholders. You can join us with your ideas, with your use cases. There are very interesting opportunities right now to participate, and yeah, this is a huge time for mobility data at the moment. So if you are interested in joining these ecosystems, then yeah, please contact us, or maybe you have some discussion points, please post them in the chat.
We can also provide last survey, a short, if you like. It's interesting, Sebastian, about are you interested in provision or using mobility data? Should we use this as well? Sebastian?
Yeah.
Should we use
another questionnaire?
What do you think?
Yes, please. Yeah. I was focusing on the chat.
Okay. So another questionnaire is, are you interested in the provision or using of mobility data? So would also be great if you give us a short feedback about this. Okay, most of you are interested in using mobility data, it seems. Some of you are also interested in providing data.
Mm-hmm.
So I show you the result of the questionnaire. Can you see this, Sebastian?
Yeah,
yeah.
Which is actually an interesting outcome, because in the current discussions within Datenraum Mobilität, for example, or mobility data space, it is mostly easier to identify oneself with the role of a data provider, because you can see the data space as a new distribution channel for your data, where you can make or provide data for new business models. But it is even harder to see which opportunities arise from the data that will be made available in the data space. So again, the question to you, if you have interesting ideas what to do with mobility data, yeah, please post them in the comments or approach us afterwards, and we can see how we can integrate or adapt the ideas into the ongoing activities. There is also a question about extended vehicle data. So first, the governance model is based on a volunteer approach. So these stakeholders that see an interest and a benefit of providing data, they are the ones that will publish their data offers. So regarding to extended vehicle, currently active in the Datenraum Mobilität activity is here, which is kind of aggregating provider, data provider, on behalf of some vehicle manufacturers. I think they will make data available on behalf of the OEMs if it's in their interest. So, and this will also comprise extended vehicle, to my knowledge. Mm-hmm. Okay, so if you're interested in these kind of data, approach us afterwards and we can see how we can bring these interests together. Okay, and Christoph also mentioned the extended development towards Gaia-X, where the IDS broker that should connect data offers and data requests together will be even extended towards Gaia-X requirements. And he mentioned also that this includes also more requirements from the data user's perspective. Okay, so we are aware that this session is between you and the lunch break. So if we have no more questions, that I think we can finish this session here at this point. Wolfgang, do you have some additional points?
No, I'm happy to see that many of you are so interested, and thank you very much for your feedback and your interest.
Okay, then thanks to all of you for joining us in this late session. And yeah, we would be very happy to get in touch with you at a later possibility. And yeah, let's see where activities can start from now on. Okay, thank you very much and see you then.